So NVIDIA says to run the RTX 3080, you at least need a 750 watt of power supply. And I guess which is what a lot of people will be going for, at least if they are building a new system. But has anyone ever wondered if a less rated power supply can run the RTX 3080 too? And I'm pretty sure you didn't, because you were busy building a new effing system and nobody cares for people with old stuff. Shame on you humans. Hey everyone, Mukul here. So recently when I was reviewing the RTX 3080, I wondered if my older PSU, which in this case was the Corsair RM650X Gold, can actually support and run the RTX 3080 for benchmarking and stuff. Or will it just trip and blow the guts out of it? Now the RM650X Gold from Corsair is a very solid power supply, and don't let the results ahead fool you and you start expecting the same performance by any lower tier PSU which you already own or are planning to buy. I had plans to eventually upgrade to a new PSU rated for higher power, and in these times when everything is crazily expensive, I somehow managed to get a good deal on the Antec HCG Gold 1000, which is of course a 1000 watts power supply. The other options from other brands at 850 watts were priced very closely to this, as I was really not able to find a good deal on them. So I put just a little more money in and got this PSU, knowingly it was a massive overkill for my system. But who doesn't like going for overkills in the PC master race? Especially if you have a healthy savings and you are literally doing nothing else in the COVID era except for staring at your screen and probably working or gaming. So I ran a bunch of tests stressing my CPU, which in this case is the Ryzen 3900X, on an ASUS TUF X570 gaming motherboard, and other stuff which is on your screen with of course the Founders Edition RTX 3080. The RTX 3080 needs two 8-pin PCIe power connectors to power on, so if you own an AIB partner card that needs more than two of them, then you can differ from this analysis. I don't have any fancy stuff in my case except for 3 ARGB fans and 3 non-lit fans. So yeah, in lump sum, even at full load, the system shouldn't eat up more than 550 or 570 watts of power. So testing the GPU first and running FurMark at 4K resolution, which utilizes most of your GPU performance, simultaneously running Cinebench R20, which uses all of your CPU cores, I could really see no dip in GPU clocks on either the 650W Corsair and the 1000W Antec. They both ran comfortably during my 20-minute test run, and they both ran almost up to 2 GHz of frequency. The power consumption scale of both these PSU in the same test stayed around the same level, and on both the power supplies, the RTX 3080 was really able to reach its maximum power consumption of 320 watts at stock settings. And if you had doubts over the CPU performance, well, the CPU clocked just slightly better on the 1000 watts Antec as compared to the Corsair 650 watts, but the difference in clocks were about 1 or 2% maximum, so it's a minor difference but a difference nonetheless. The power consumption was about the same though, as it ranged around 141 watts on both the PSUs, so a big frigging zero here in terms of any performance difference. And how cleverly I have shared CPU stats on the 650 watt power supply with you over a video which was meant to be for the RTX 3080's performance on this power supply. Checking the total power consumption of the whole system during all of these different tests, the Antec tried to consume less power than Corsair. Even though both of them were gold rated PSUs, the Antec had more headroom, and maybe that's why it performed more efficiently. So yeah, clearly a good 650 watt PSU can run your RTX 3080 without any issue at stock settings, but there was an instance wherein a specific boss stage during one of my Doom Eternal gameplays, the game just shut off twice, and then only I was able to clear it in the third attempt. So that could have been either because the card might have tried to pull more power than the PSU could supply at that specific moment, or it could just have been the game's bug. And because the RTX 3080 has tendencies of spiking even above the permissible TDP sometimes, as some of the more veteran reviewers like Steve from GamerNexus have specified in their articles, so keeping that in mind, it's probably safer to invest in a higher rated PSU, but you don't need to panic about it till you can find one at an acceptable price these days. APTD. Well, these times of pandemic and me coining these useless abbreviations. But if you ever plan to overclock your card, then forget you ever saw this video and get a 850 watt rated power supply at least for the RTX 3080 in your system. So do leave a like and sub with the bell if this video helped you in any way, and join our Discord server if you want to further dwell on this with us there. Stay safe humans, that's all for today. MewBot out.